A very good morning to all of my dear students. Welcome back to your online class. And in previous class, we have just finished the chapter 1, that is nutrition in plants. And we have discussed all the subtopics under this chapter. And if you have any problem from this chapter, you can ask me today. Any problem from the chapter nutrition in plants, you can ask me. No problem. Okay, so today I will ask you some question. Be ready everyone, I will ask you some question that may be short question type, MCQ type or fill in the blanks or short answer type question. Okay, so is everyone ready? Now I am going to ask you some question. Starting from fill in the blanks. Listen carefully everyone. Listen carefully. Question: all organisms take dash and utilize it to get energy for the growth and maintenance of their bodies. Again I am repeating. All organisms take dash and utilize it to get energy for the growth and maintenance of their bodies. Yes, very good. Most of you have given the correct answer. The correct answer will be food. Yes, obviously it will be food. Now, the next question for you, that is, green plants synthesize their food by themselves by the process of dash and they are called dash. Green plants synthesize their food by the process of dash and they are called dash. Please answer. Answer first. Yes, I have just asked for two fill in the blanks there. By the process of dash and they are called dash. Two answer you have to give. Yes, the first question, first answer, first fill in the blanks is photosynthesis, by the process of photosynthesis, and they are called autotrophs. Okay? Yes. Okay, why you are so late? Please join first at the time. Now the next question for you, that is, dash energy is stored by the leaves with the help of chlorophyll. Dash energy is stored by the leaves with the help of chlorophyll. What will be the answer? Okay, no issue. You have joined, just it is fine. Okay, no problem. Just concentrate in your class. I am asking you some question. Just try to give answer from the chapter nutrition in plants. The last question from this chapter I have asked, that was dash energy is stored by the leaves with the help of chlorophyll. What will be the answer? You have to name the energy. What type of energy? Yes, you know that that is sunlight, but there is a particular name of that energy. What is that? Solar energy. Okay, solar energy. Understood everyone? The answer will be solar energy. Yes. Now the next question for you, that is, dash derived nutrition form dead and decaying matter. Dash derived nutrition form dead and decaying matter. Answer. answer first? Yes. Saprotrophs. Yes. Saprotrophs. Not saprotrophic. Saprotrophic is the mode of nutrition. The organisms, they possess such nutrition, they are called saprotrophs. Okay? Saprotrophs will be the answer. Okay? Okay. Now we are proceeding towards the next question. Plants like cascata, they take food from dash plant. Plant like cascata, they take food from dash plant. Very good. The answer is host. Okay, my voice is fluctuating. Let me check the setting, okay? Don't worry. Clear? Okay, thank you. Now my next question for you, that is, all animals are categorized as, you have to answer this. Very good. Heterotrophs. Yes, heterotrophs. All animals are categorized as heterotrophs. Okay. Next question for you. That is, DAS is produced and DASH is utilized during photosynthesis. DAS is produced and DAS is utilized during photosynthesis. You have to mention it in gaseous form. You know. Yes. Please tell. DAS is produced and DASH is utilized during photosynthesis. Yes. First answer will be oxygen. Okay. Oxygen is produced, a lot amount of oxygen is produced, as you know, and carbon dioxide is utilized from the air. Okay. O2 is the chemical formula and carbon dioxide, that is CO2. Okay, everyone understood? Now my next question for you, that is, DAS is the site of reception of light energy in leaves. DASH is the site of reception of light energy in the leaves. Please tell, who can say the answer? No. Spelling is not correct. Please check your spelling, Tari. Yes. Okay, I am repeating the question. That is, DASH is the site of reception of light energy. DASH is the site of reception of light energy in the leaves. You have to say the answer. This way, the reception of light takes place in leaves. Okay. So here the answer will be obviously chlorophyll. All of you have answered. Thank you for your answer. Now my next question for you. write, sorry, give examples of symbiotic organisms. Give examples of symbiotic organisms. Mean in symbiotic relationship, there are two organisms. So you have to name the two organisms which are in a symbiotic relationship with each other. They are mutually benefited from each other, as you know. Okay, they are interdependent on each other by some means. So what are the example of symbiotic organisms? Please check your spelling, algae. And what is the association called? Where algae and fungi or alga or fungus, they live together. That is known as, what is that term known as? Yes, very good. That is lichens. Yes. Another example can you give? Another example. During your class, I have already discussed those examples with you all. What are other examples of these symbiotic relationships organism? No, not including lichen. Except lichen, what are the other symbiotic organisms? I have told you. Remember, rhizobium with which organism? You have to say it properly. Rhizobium and? Okay, no issue, Shruti. No issue. Now you can join. This video will be uploaded in the YouTube channel, so please check this video from your e-portal, also from your YouTube channel. And you can see this from our YouTube channel. I am just asking for that rhizobium, that is a nitrogen fixing bacteria, that is also playing a major role with a symbiotic relationship or a symbiosis with the root of leguminous plant. I have told you. So there is a symbiotic relationship between rhizobium and leguminous plant also. Yes. So that will be the answer. Okay. And you know that rhizobium that fix nitrogen into its soluble form, that is nitrate, and in return the plants provide food and shelter to rhizobium. Okay. So they are in a symbiotic relationship. Now, next question for you, that is, what do you mean by saprotrophic mode of nutrition? What do you mean by saprotrophic mode of nutrition? Please tell me. What do you mean by saprotrophic mode of nutrition? Just asking for what is saprotrophic mode of nutrition. Yes, Shruta, your answer is correct. The saprophytic plants or the saprotrophs like fungi, the secrete digestive juice on the dead decaying organic matter and convert it into solution, and by this way they take their food. Okay. Yes, yes. Yes, Nishad, you have just copied this answer. Yes, Tanujit, you are also correct. Yes. What is the favorable condition when fungi can grow rapidly? What do you think? What is the favorable condition for them? For their growth. Yes, I have seen everyone answer. Hot and humid weather. That is the rainy season, you know. mostly rainy season. Weather spelling is wrong. Weather, W-E-A-T-H-E-R. Weather. Check your spelling, Tari. Yes. Now, my next question is, name one parasitic plant. Name one parasitic plant. What is this? Again, spelling is wrong. You have written TTA. No, Cuscuta or Amarbel. Very good. Cuscuta. Only TA. Yes. That should be the answer. And last question for you. The end products of photosynthesis are. What are the end products of photosynthesis? You have to say what are the end products of photosynthesis. What are the end products of photosynthesis? I am not asking for attendance now, so don't leave now. I am again asking you a question that what is the end product of, what are the end products of photosynthesis? End product I am asking for, Subhajit. You have written sunlight. How can you say? These are the things which are required, which are as taken as raw materials. You have written whatever there. What are the end products? Only glucose. Glucose as in the form of carbohydrate and another thing. Glucose and starch both in the form of carbohydrate, you know. And yes, very good, Anusha. That is oxygen is released. You have forgot. Carbohydrate and oxygen. Carbohydrate in the form of glucose and starch, and you know the difference between glucose and starch. Glucose is the simple sugar made of only one sugar, but starch is complex sugar made of more than one or two sugar. So we have seen the starch is actually stored in the plants. Now we have finished asking question. I am now finishing the question. Okay.